What do you do after you close your first deal or any deal? Stay tuned. We're going to teach you how to perpetuate growth and longevity in this business and life. Going to the boardroom. So, welcome to the boardroom. So, we're going to talk about what you do after you close your first deal or your 100th deal or your 1,000th. And a lot of you guys aren't really going to agree on me, but I've seen some pretty bad things happen to people over the years. Closing a real estate transaction is difficult. Some people think it's impossible. This business isn't for everybody, but it must be for you because you're here on this channel. And by the way, don't forget to smash that subscribe button. Hopefully by giving you these 5 steps that I apply literally with almost every transaction we go through, and we've been through over 1,000, you'll be in this business for as long as we are, and it's almost 2 decades and maybe even longer. So the first thing I'm gonna be a huge advocate of is, once you get something closed, please, for the love of God, celebrate. I understand if it's your first transaction, you may be ecstatic, you may be euphoric, or you may be like me and you didn't sleep for 20 days and you're just gonna wanna go home and take a nap and sleep for 14 hours, and if that's it, great, do it. And if not, maybe go on vacation. If it was big enough, that's possibly the right idea. Or just go out to eat, take your team out to eat. Maybe go out to eat with your girlfriend or your boyfriend, your significant other, but do something a little bit out of the ordinary, because honestly, you're watching this channel and you're in this business, or you're trying to be, and that makes you a little bit out of the ordinary to begin with. A lot of people tell me, hey, Chuck, I want your life, I want your lifestyle. Well, maybe if you just got something closed, it's time to start living it right now. And I think you should really do something special for yourself, just to remind you that, hey, I did something most people can't do, and every time I do the impossible over and over again and it's a habit, yeah, we celebrate a little bit. I don't care, go outside and smoke a cigar. Do you, whatever makes you happy. You can even come up with a schedule of how you're gonna celebrate. If it's a 5-figure deal, maybe go out to eat. If it's a 6-figure deal, you could plan a trip. If you close something even bigger, you have your first $1 million year, try something that most people can't ever do, and I've been fortunate enough to do it a lot in my life. Take a month off. Go live somewhere. Go to Costa Rica. Rent a convertible and drive cross country. Go to Brazil. Do you. Check out. Think about what it is you want to do. It's amazing what you're going to come back with. Segues directly into time off. I have tons of friends that have done hundreds of deals over the years that are my age, give or take a few years. And every time I would close a deal, and sometimes we'd be working out of the same office, sometimes I wouldn't show up the next day, or maybe I'd take a Monday or a Friday off or even a week, and they'd be right there working, grinding, trying to throw more money on the pile. And what I've realized over the years is, somehow magically, these people burn out. They have heart attacks. These are the people that are having strokes. It's like they didn't take any time for themselves, and why build it if you're not there to enjoy it? Time off is incredibly important. Time away from your phone, time away from your technology, even if it's a day, even if it's a couple hours, whether you just closed your first deal or you just closed your 100th, every time you do one, please, 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 just take a day off and step away from everything and reflect and think and figure out what it is that you really want. Because honestly, you wanted to do this business for you to have a better life, and what good is life if you can't live it, or if you don't have the health to do it in the first place? Detach and reflect. This is incredibly important. When you take the time off, phone off, okay? Everything away, maybe bring a notebook and a pen, or maybe just do nothing. Spend the day talking to the one that you love. I know I just took my significant other to the Dominican Republic, and we got this little private suite where we had a butler, and the butler didn't really show up for the first 4 days, and that's because I tipped him $200 to not show up, because I just wanted to be left alone and I wanted to reconnect with her. I'd spent a tremendous amount of time working really hard, and I just didn't want to look at my phone, and I wanted to reflect on what it is and where I was going and where we were going, and really just wrap my head around life in general, because all real estate investment is a vehicle to get you where you go. I'm gonna tell you guys a secret. I don't even like real estate, and I don't really like the concept of money. I like solving problems. I like helping people, and that's why I fell in love with this. And I figured that out when I detached and reflected on why I really like this. After that, when you get back from your little mini vacation or mega vacation, whatever it is that you did, and I understand you don't understand the importance of celebrating, taking time off, and detaching and reflecting yet if you haven't done this or closed the deal, but you will, because when you get back, you're going to hit it really hard. You're going to look at this huge chunk of money that you have, and maybe it's 20 grand, maybe it's 50, maybe it's a couple hundred, but you're going to burn through it really quick if you try to live that hip-hop lifestyle and you're buying stupid cars and that's not important. And it's almost cool to have money and just not let people know that you have it. And I like to do stupid things like when I'm celebrating and you go out to eat at Houston's or one of these semi-fancy restaurants, or even the other day we went to Chick-fil-A. I don't wait on lines. I can't do it. My time's valuable. A 50 or 100, you don't need a reservation. You get your table immediately. Your ass is kissed, and they call it a love story. Allocate the rest of your funds to things that are important. You should definitely have a substantial ocean fund. However, as an investor, as you get more and more confident, you will realize that you can draw down money from everywhere in your network and banks and different houses that you may own. But still, you should have money sidelined in case something goes wrong. And something always goes wrong. Look at the pandemic right now and the race riots. I didn't plan on any of this stuff happening. I'll be the first one to tell you, did I plan on having money set aside? Yes. Was I in a better position than I thought I would have been? Yeah, a lot of that was just dumb luck, but I still would have been okay if it didn't happen. Okay, allocate funds towards marketing. The only thing that's going to grow your business is reaching out to more distressed sellers or having them reach out to you, and come up with a plan for growth. And this is where you really start to think after you've been in business for a year, maybe two, is it time that I hire somebody? My time is valuable. There's only two things you can do in business to grow: magnify, putting yourself in front of a lot of people at once, which is, by the way, what we're doing with this YouTube channel. I hope you guys like it. I hope you smash the subscribe button and like the video. The other thing you can do is multiply, and that's building little clones of yourself and hiring people and taking on partners that are better at things than you are, which is why I have a bookkeeper, which is why I have somebody who does my short sales. Guys, you like the YouTube channel? Don't thank me, thank Elvis, because I have no idea how to do any of this stuff, and he's incredibly talented. He's the dude who's been bringing you this. Come up with a plan for growth. The less you do, the more you make. Do what you're good at. My job is talking to people and buying houses and networking. We're networking with you right now. We'd like to get to know all of you better. My name's Chuck Kohout. This is Always Be Closing. Don't forget to smash that subscribe button, hit the like button, share this video on your social media, and I look forward to meeting you in person someday soon. Bye for now.